हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज विजय कुमार एंड वी आर स्टडिंग रेफ्रिजरेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग। इन द लास्ट वीडियो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड अबाउट द बूटस्ट्रैप एयर रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम दैट वाज विदाउट इवेपोरेटर। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी द बूटस्ट्रैप एयर रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम विद इवेपोरेटर। लेट्स स्टार्ट। Bootstrap aircraft refrigeration cycle with evaporator. What will happen? You know very well, from 1 to 2 dash is a ramming process, 2 dash to 3 dash is a actual adiabatic compression process which is occurring in compressor. Now from 3 dash to 4 it is happening in heat exchanger 1. This is the bootstrap system, you know very well. 3 dash to 4 dash it is happening in heat exchanger 1. Okay, now from 4 to 5 dash, this process is happening in a secondary compressor. I have already explained in my last video. Okay, now after 5 dash to 6, the process is going on in heat exchanger 2. This is the heat exchanger 2. Okay, now from here, from this point you have to take care. We will see what will happen. Now from this point number 6, the air will go to the evaporator. This is my evaporator. So after the heat exchanger and before the cooling turbine, we have placed evaporator. So this cycle, bootstrap air refrigeration cycle, will become with evaporator. Okay, so now this process will not be taking place. So I'll delete this. Now I think you got the idea. Up to 6 point you are very clear. I thought it is very clear up to point number 6. Now from 6 to 7, air will go to the evaporator. At constant pressure, heat rejection will take place. In evaporator. My friends, it is also like a heat exchanger. So at constant pressure, heat rejection is taking place in evaporator. So if I draw, in this case, this is the constant pressure line. So this is point number 7. And this is point number 6, this is point number 7. If I say this amount of heat is rejecting in evaporator, so my friends, this is the amount of heat which is rejecting in evaporator, QR evaporator. Okay. Now, again, then air will go to the cooling turbine. In cooling turbine, you are very smart. I have already explained so many times. What will happen? In cooling turbine, this air will expand. Not isentropically, adiabatically, the air will expand. So if I draw these pressure line, if I draw these pressure line here, so then air will expand in secondary turbine like this. This is an isentropic process. But due to irreversibility in the turbine, this air will expand adiabatically. So the process will go like this. So I will do the dotted line for this process. Then this is 7 to 8 and this is 8 dash. Now 7 to 8 dash is a actual process, actual expansion of air in cooling turbine. Okay, now from point 8 dash the air will go again in cabin. Now you can easily see what will happen in cabin. So many times I have explained, in cabin, this air will take heat from the cabin and So refrigeration process will occur in cabin. So this is 0.8-9. So this will not be 7 dash, and this will not be the 8. Okay, if I draw, this is the point number 9. If I say this is point number 9. So in this case, the heat rejection is taking place up to point heat addition is up to 8-9 heat addition will take place. So you can see easily how much amount of heat is adding. So refrigeration effect in this case is also more in comparison to the without evaporator case. So in with evaporator, refrigeration effect is more. Okay, and COP is more. You can easily compare all these things. Okay friends, this is the Q heat addition. If I delete this, this is the Q heat addition in the bootstrap air refrigeration cycle with evaporator. And again in evaporator, we will use the substance ammonia, alcohol, water for cooling the air. I hope all these things it is clear. Okay, so friends, I'll not do the analysis of all these processes. I'm again I'm telling that with the help of a steady flow energy equation, you can calculate all the values like heat addition, WC work in the compressor, WT work output from the turbine, QR heat rejection in heat exchanger 1, heat rejection in heat exchanger 2, and heat rejection in evaporator. You can easily use steady flow energy equation to calculate all these values. So my friends, we have seen in this video bootstrap air refrigeration cycle with evaporator. One more thing you have to remember, bootstrap aircraft refrigeration cycle is used in the high speed aircraft system. This thing we will study when I'll explain about the DART. I'll explain about the DART, D-A-R-T. This will be explained in my future videos. So thanks for watching this video and have a good day.